There's a 95-year-old version of us that you introduced us to. You said, guys, and this was the first day I met you. Right. Imagine this 95-year-old you. If you could be with that person, what advice would that person have for you about what matters and what doesn't? And man, did that give people some powerful insights. What other tools, perspectives, games, exercises can really get someone to get in touch with a totally different perspective? Or is that the only one?
Well, let me give you another one. It's in my next book. It's called The Earned Life. I'm a Buddhist, so most of what I teach is kind of Buddhist stuff anyway, but this is very Buddhist. So the Buddhist philosophy is every time I take a deep breath, it's a new me. So take a deep breath. You think, new me, new me, new me. Everything that happened before this second in your life was done by an infinite set of people. Their names were the previous yous. So think of the previous yous. Think of all the gifts they've given the you that's listening to me right now. Think about how hard they tried. And think about all the nice things they did for other people. If anybody did all those nice things, what should you say to those people? You say, thank you, thank you, thank you. Now, did they make some mistakes or two? Let go. So when you think this way, the first part of it is relieving. It's easier to forgive for yourself. And I tell people, look, I've asked a zillion people around the world this question. My child grows up, I want my child to be. What's the number one word? By far, more than every other word combined in any country, happy. You want your kids to be happy? You want your people you love to be happy? You want your parents to be happy? The people who work with you to be happy? You go first. You want them to forgive themselves? You go first. You forgive yourself. So the first part of the exercise is thinking about all the previous yous and really putting you in that mood of saying, wait a minute, thank them for all they've done.